Conditional formatting allows you to format the contents or the format a cell differently depending on what's in that cell or in other cells. The best way to show you is with some examples. So here, for example, we've got some revenue growth, and these are the growths in different branches. We want to have anything that's, let's say, less than 10% turn red. Let's say above 30% it must turn green, and anything between must be yellow. So we could do it manually, but what that means is next month we're going to have to manually redo it again. We continually need to check. So what we should be able to do is I can highlight those cells, I go to the Home tab, Conditional Format. Now the actual tool is down here, New Rule and Manage Rules, but you'll see there's some wizards which help us do certain standard things. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to say if it's greater than 30%, we want it to turn green. So I'm going to click on greater than. You'll see Excel guesses 15%. We're going to just change that and make it 30%. So it's going to say that any cell that is greater than 30% is going to be formatted, and Excel has guessed light red full with dark red text. You can see there's some standard colorings, but we're going to go to the custom format. And this is your normal format cells. So you'll see you can change the number categories. You can play with some font items. You can mess around with the border. And the most common one is we can fill it with a color. So I'm going to say turn it green, please. So when I say OK, you'll see it automatically turns it green. And if I say OK, that one is automatically turned green. If I want to add another one on, so now we want between, let's say 10 and 30% must be yellow. Again, the cells are highlighted. I go back to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, and you'll see one of the options is between. So I'm going to say between. Excel guesses again. So I'm going to say between 10% and 30%. Again, it's going to use light red full with dark red text. I could use yellow. That's what it looks like. Well, I'm going to go to custom and choose that yellow there. Say OK. So we've now added two conditional formats on. I'm going to add a third one. I'm going to say highlight cell rules. You'll see the option here is less than. I'm going to say less than 10%. And this one, I'm going to make it red. So when I say OK, what we've now got is three conditional formats on these cells. The benefit of conditional formatting is if it turns out that that's not 21%, but actually 2.1%, when I click Enter, you'll see it turns red because that is below 10% and it knows it must turn red in that case. Just before we continue and show you some of the other things you can do, I just want to show you what's actually happening here. So I'm going to highlight those cells again, go to Home, Conditional Format, and at the bottom here you'll see it says Manage Rules. So when I click on it, it will show you all the conditional formats you have either on the current selection, what we've selected, or there's a couple of other options here. For each of these, you can click on them. You'll see you can delete, you can edit, or you can create a new rule. You can move them up or down. So if I go here and I say edit rule, you'll see this pops up, quite similar, maybe not as user-friendly as the wizard, but it should be clear to you. So you can see it says cell value, less than, and all of these things you can change, and you can change the number. Just going back to what you can do from the wizard's point of view, with these we actually typed in the numbers, but maybe what we want is the color to change based on a number in another cell. So here this benchmark is gross profit of 30%. I want these to turn green if they're bigger than that, or red if they're less than that. So the process is pretty similar. Home, conditional formatting, highlight cell rules. the one I want is greater than. And now instead of typing this in here, I can go and just click on that cell. So what Excel is now going to do is compare the contents of these to whatever's in there. This time I'm going to use the green fill, and when I say OK, these all turn green because they're bigger than 30%. If we now change it and maybe it needs to be bigger than 34%, you'll see automatically only those two get the green coloring because the benchmark has changed. Let's just change it back to 30%. Another thing you can do, and highlight those, you'll see we've looked at most of these, greater than, less than, between, etc. You can see we've got an option of text that contains date occurring and duplicate values. There's also a whole bunch of top and bottom rules, so you can highlight the top 10 items, top 10%, bottom, etc. You can also highlight the above average. So when I click on above average, it asks for what color you're going to use. I'm going to say, so we're happy with red because this is operating expenses to revenue, so we want to, these are bad. When I say OK, what Excel has done is looked at those cells, got an average, and then anything that's above average is colored. So if, for example, this number changes to 29%, you'll see it adjusts the average and then highlights those. Just looking here, so we've looked at the top and bottom rules. If you want, there's always a more rules option, so you can click on it, and this goes through the actual tool where you can now choose a whole selection of items. So those are the standard ones, these up here. There are a couple of others. So let's look here. I've got a whole bunch of data, it goes downwards, and we want to somehow show which time is the biggest item here. And you can see it's quite hard to see, to spot perhaps that is the biggest. If I highlight these cells, I go to conditional formatting, there's something called data bars. And the easiest way to show you is just to click on it, and when I click on it, you can see that what it's doing is showing me what is putting a little bar chart within the cell. So it's very easy to spot that that one over there is the biggest, that's the second biggest. So visually it's a lot easier to spot, and if these change, then the bar charts change as well. Similarly, here we've got a mortgage repayments. So there's a matrix here of how long do we get to pay it off, what's the interest rate. We now want to easily see where the biggest and smallest numbers are. I can highlight it. If I go to conditional formatting, there's something called color scales. Again, a whole bunch of options. I'm going to choose the second one. When I click on it, you can see what it's doing is it's coloring the cells from darkest red to darkest green, and then a whole bunch of colors in between depending on the size of the number. And in this case, it's going through yellow. So you can see it's a lot easier to spot where the cheapest is and where the most expensive is. Finally, you've got a whole bunch of icons. So just to show you here, I've got a whole bunch of projects, and this is how complete the projects are. Visually, it might be easier to show some sort of a graphic. So if I go to conditional formatting, under icon set, you'll see there's a whole bunch of different icons. You can have arrows, robots, ticks and crosses, cell phone signals. And the one I want to look at here is this one here, which is sort of a percentage project complete. So for now, I'm going to just click on that. And what you'll see, it immediately puts in the correct icon depending on what it thinks these numbers represent. I'll explain to you this a little bit later of how it's coming up with this and how you can adjust it. Risk rating, so these are the risks of these projects. We want to use the robots, red, yellow, green. I've got a conditional formatting, icons, and you'll see there's some robots. When I click on them, you'll see we've got that. Now these risk ratings, we're going to want to change this around. The bigger the number, the bigger the risk. So I'm going to show you how to do that just now. But that's how simple it is to add colors onto these cells, and they'll automatically do it when the numbers change. Now let's understand how Excel has decided what should be red, yellow, and green, and what should be filled in here. In the first part, it was very explicit. You specified exactly what you wanted to see, and the colors were done. When it came to these labels, the color matrix, and the icons, Excel has to do some guesswork. So if I just highlight these, go to conditional formatting, and I look at manage rules, what you'll see, I'm going to go to the data bars one and say edit. This is how Excel has decided what these should look like. So you'll see the format style is due on a data bar, an icon set, etc. Notice you can decide whether you want to show the bar only. So do you want to see these numbers or not? If I say show bar only, you'll see you don't see the numbers. They're still there, but you don't see them. I'm just going to put it back on so we can actually see them. You'll see then it specifies, how do we know what the minimum is and what the maximum is? Excel has decided to automatically guess that the minimum bar is automatic, but I can say, well, actually no, minimum must be the lowest value, for example, or a certain number, or a certain percent. So if I go to the lowest value, when I say okay, you'll see it changes slightly, and what it's decided is the lowest value it sees over here is going to be the very smallest bar. If I go here and I choose that the maximum is the highest value, when I say okay and apply, this one here fills the entire bar. This may not be what you want though, so maybe you want to specify that a certain percent must be the highest value and a certain percent must be the lowest value. This is a bit confusing in Excel, so we're going to explain that just now. So that's that one there. If I come down here, highlight these, manage rules, edit, you'll see this is slightly different. So now what it's saying is, what is your style? Is it a two color or three color scale? Notice you can decide yourself how the color should work. So you can choose any color, through any color, to any color. And again, you can decide, how does it determine the minimum color? So what's going to turn this green? Is it the lowest value, a number, percent, etc.? The midpoint, so at the moment it's saying, look at the middle of these two, that'll be the yellow, but you may want to specify a certain number. So if I say the number is the midpoint, and let's say I decide that this bright yellow must be, let's choose that number there, 9347. 9347, highest value, that's fine. When I say okay, just watch what happens to that. You'll see it now adjusts this color scheme so that this is yellow. The best way, however, to understand all of this is actually with the icons. So let's just start with the risk rating. So firstly, you can see this is going the wrong way. The lowest number should be green. So firstly, I'm going to go and highlight it. Manage rules, edit. So what you'll see now, again, you can specify the icon. What are you using? An icon set. Notice there is a reverse icon order. So notice it goes green, yellow, red. When I click reverse, now it's going red, yellow, green. So if I said OK and applied it, so that's already a lot better. It's reversed it. Then you'll see it tries to explain to you, it's going to turn red when the value is bigger than or equal to 67%. Now you've got to be a little bit careful here. This word percent is not the same as that there, the percent there. This is actually more percentile. So you'll see it saying it must turn red when the value is bigger than or equal to 67%. This effectively is looking at the smallest number, the biggest number, working out the difference between the two, and then the top 67% of it will turn red. If we decide, for example, that there's a set number, so we've decided that only when it's above 90% do we want it to turn red. The way we tell Excel that is we're going to say turn red when the value is bigger than or equal to. I'm going to change this percent to rather say number, and I'm going to type my percentage in there, because remember percent is actually just a number, 0.90. I'm then going to say I want it to be yellow, so let's be extreme and say anything from that 90% all the way down to 10%. So I'm going to say, again, I need to change that to number. So it must be yellow when it's less than 0.9. Notice it automatically put it in. And bigger than or equal to 10. Just make sure that's a number. Oh, sorry. So you'll see that it had automatically then adjusted its calculation so that it'll be red when it's bigger than 90%, yellow when it's less than whatever the red one is, but bigger than 10%, and green when it's less than 10%. So there's no gaps here. When I say OK and apply, you'll see now I've controlled how that works. Same thing with project completion. Excel has guessed, so you'll see that 39% is showing as not really done at all, which doesn't make sense to me, and this is because by default Excel uses this percentage, and in its terminology 39% is the smallest number, 95% is the biggest number, so that's finished, that's not finished, it's not even started, and then these are adjustments of it. But what I would say is perhaps we want to link it, so there's five items, so let's do it in gaps of 20%. So I'm going to say that must be a number, 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 number. So it's going to be 0.8, 0.6, 0.4, 0.2. When I say OK and apply it, so this now makes more sense to me. That's just a quarter done, that's basically finished, that's a half done, etc. So with all the conditional formatting, you're able to edit it, and for the most part, it's fairly logical over here.